Hello and welcome to another episode of Women Locked Up Before and After. Look, today I have something to share with you. I was going through some things that I had in a folder that I got that I had in prison, and I want y'all to hear. That's why I named the title the title is on this video, because of what I'm fixing to read you. It's very short, but it's very good. So please hear this. Once upon a time, there was a rebellious little sparrow who decided not to fly south for the winter. As a cold freeze set in, he realized he had made a mistake and blatantly tried to make the trip. But the frigid air soon froze his wings and he fell to the ground, landing in a farm pasture. Just as the little sparrow thought that he would freeze to death, a cow came walking by and crapped on the little sparrow. He thought, surely this is the end. But the manure warmed the little sparrow and began defrosting his wings. Surprised and elated, the sparrow began to chirp and sing happily. Then a nearby cat, upon hearing the happy bird, found the sparrow, cleared away the manure, and promptly ate the little sparrow. The morals of the story. Number one, not everyone who craps on you is your enemy. Number two, not everyone who gets you out of crap is your friend. Number three, if you're warm and happy in a pile of crap, keep your mouth shut. I had to share this because it's a little thing that they gave us in this class. It's got a little sparrow at the very top. As you can see, it was something that we got in the class that I was in, that 1A program that I've been telling everybody that's really good. And also, this video also, I want to explain that I'm fixing to enter a transition phase on my channel. It's going to be broken into different pieces throughout the video and everything. And or different videos, I mean, and I want everybody to play, especially the ones that are looking, that are just now getting out, fresh out of the penitentiary, prison, whatever. This is not just for women, this is for men also. Yes, it's based on what I got from a women's prison, you know, I was locked up in, but it's very useful. It's on transition, and again, first and foremost, before I'm going to try to make this video really short, first and foremost, transition, the definition of it, if anybody does not know, which I'm sure you do, but I'm going to make that first. Transition, movement, passage, or change from one position, state, stage, subject, concept, etc., to another change. The transition from adolescence to adulthood. It's just, you know, I wanted to share that, you know, that's the definition of transition. But we all know when we're coming out of prison or whatever, transition is pretty much like a point in your life where you're trying to find out what the next stage of your life is going to be, your goals and everything that you, and getting out and what your plans are, like, same thing as gold, but I mean, the first part I want to share about the transition before I get off this video is that, first of all, under transition, talks about family members. This may be your family, family unit, household members, or a particular individual, parent, spouse, sibling, etc., that you're going to be associating with when you get out. Experiences during imprisonment. You and your family member have lived through many different circumstances during your time of incarceration. It may take a while to learn what it has really been like for you or them, both of you. You have led a very protected and structured existence within the confines of prison life and may have difficulty adjusting to the responsibilities of everyday life on the outside. Additionally, you may have an emotional experiences which your family member may find difficult to talk about. And that's another thing. A lot of people talk about these things when they're locked up. They're talking about how they want to be with their family, and they want to talk to their family, they want to make amends and everything, and that's really good to do that. And there's some that don't want to do that. Well, you know, sometimes it's too soon. That time will come. It might take a little time, but it will come. One more thing, loss of communication. Even during the best times on visits and during telephone calls, communications may have been strained. Talking about feelings may have been avoided because it was too painful or difficult. Communication through letters and phone calls may have been restricted to urgent matters. You may have avoided letting your family member know about life in prison in order to prevent from worrying, for them from worrying. Change of rules. Your family member may have gained a greater sense of independence during your period of incarceration. Your family member may have become responsible for matters which you used to handle. Both you and your family member need to be patient and aware that roles may be changing again. Expectations. You and your family member will likely have your own expectations of what will happen once you both reunite. For example, both of you have hopes in terms of finding work, living arrangements, and for relationships that were left behind. Life as your family member knew is going to be, you know, it's going to be different. Your family member should consider counseling prior to and after your release. So, that is one main reason why I wanted to start this transitional phase thing with everyone, because I know it's going to help people in the long run whenever you know. I mean, everybody's going to face these obstacles when they get out. I mean, I definitely did. And one more thing I want to add to this last one, on adjustments. Sorry, my hair being weird right now. You may have been away so long. Hang on, okay. On adjustment, you may have been away so long that you feel totally disoriented and out of touch with life in the community. For example, you may have become unfamiliar with how much things actually cost. You may also have children who have grown up in your absence. The time spent apart from your children might mean that you feel distance from them. Additionally, you may require time to let go of habits acquired while in prison, such as being up for the facility count, etc. I don't want to read any more of this because, like I said, the next part of it is parole, and I want to go through a phase of these. So the next few times you see a video, it's going to be titled Transition, and whatever subject is going to be on right beside that. But yes, definitely this is really helpful to, like I said, mainly for the people who have just gotten out, fresh out of penitentiary or prison, men or women, does not matter, because this goes for anybody. But like I said, I definitely went through a lot of problems, and I actually still am to this day. I still have issues right now. Of course, I'm sure people have heard, you know, in some videos I talk about my daughter, and she holds a lot of resentment still, and that's when you're going to be looking at, you know, everyone's going to be looking at stuff like that, especially if you had problems with any kind of addiction in the past, or don't have to be addiction, it can be anything, any way you hurt your family in any kind of way. I mean, you're going to be looking at ways to, you know, get close to your family once again, or your children, anybody. But yes, I wanted to share this with everybody, but like I said, the next couple of videos will be on the transition, because it's really important when you're getting out or when you're fixing to get out. So I really hope everybody enjoyed that. I know that little poem like thing I read at the beginning, it sounded kind of, at first you probably thought, oh gosh, she's reading this some kind of childish thing or whatever, but it made a lot of sense, didn't it? But anyway, I want to share that with y'all, and I hope y'all enjoy. If you like this video, please like it and comment below if you have went through this or you're going through it or whatever. Just let me know. In the meantime, if you haven't already subscribed, please subscribe and please like, share, and subscribe. And peace and love, y'all. Bye.